Howdy everyone, this is Trisha and welcome to my channel. Today I'm doing a vlog and by the title you see that I'm going to be transforming a basic pinata into something a little more special. And this is going to be for my grandson's second birthday. So Saturday, May the 15th is his second birthday. So happy birthday, Leo, because I know you'll be watching this and I know probably you'll watch it in the future, I hope. So this is your grandma working on a pinata for you. All right, so I'm not only going to be working on the pinata, but I'm also going to be working on a little cake topper. Now, I don't know for sure that we're going to use this because I've got some other little ideas that could be used for the topping the cake. My daughter-in-law is ordering just a basic plain cake, and we're going to, I got some items to decorate it. And she asked me about a cake topper because she did order a party pack with some plates, cups, and things like that. And it comes with a banner that says happy birthday with a dinosaur theme to it. But there was not much other decoration, and it did come with one of those honeycomb table toppers, so a little decoration for the table, but not with anything for the cake specifically. And she also asked about a candle, so we were talking about this going back and forth, and I told her, hey, I'm going to take care of all of this. You don't worry about it. She's a teacher. She's super busy. The days are just kind of going by. She didn't know if she wanted to make anything, you know, a little bit bigger. So this is just going to be just us. Basically, we're going to take off early tomorrow morning. So this was yesterday when we discussed this, and I said, hey, I'll take care of it. She wanted to know if I could maybe get some more stuff to decorate the wall so we could have a nice little backdrop. So I've got stuff right here. I've got all my stuff right here on the table, but I'm not going to discuss a lot of that. What I'm going to do is, excuse me, my goodness, when I get over there, I'll probably do another little video and just say, hey, look, there's the little pictures and of the, you know, whatever I did, however we decorated and possibly the cake, how it looks finally. But I want to show you how you can take something basic and create something, you know, like the cake topper, but mainly the piñata. So the thing is that she was thinking about a piñata. My husband and I have been thinking about a piñata too. I didn't know if she wanted one, and it's not necessarily something that, oh, we gotta get a piñata. But it was one of those things like, well, if you find one, get it. So since she's very busy, like I said, I'll take care of everything. So I went to different places. I went to Walmart. They had a very basic dinosaur shape-ish, kind of rectangular. If you go online on Walmart, you'll see what I'm talking about. It's $24.99, and it's a very flat, just a kind of rectangle flat. It's got an eye on one side, an eye on the other, and I think it had part, maybe like a mouth or something, like a teeth, but it wasn't like, I don't know, I'm sorry, I'm drooling, you guys. I don't know. I'm talking too much, probably, like usual. But anyway, it didn't have like a real shape of a dinosaur, and I thought, I want my grandson to look at it and know, oh, that is a dinosaur. He's 2 years old. He knows what dinosaurs are. He plays with little dinosaurs. He loves them. He loves little trucks and little dinosaurs. That's his thing right now. So he knows the shape and he knows the dinosaur. So I thought, he's going to look at that. He's not going to see. He might not see a dinosaur except for the eyeballs and maybe some of the teeth. I don't know. So that was going to be my last choice. But then my mom reminded me of a piñateria, which is specifically a piñata store. So they specialize in piñatas. And I went and talked to the lady, and she's got tons of piñatas. I asked her, do you have dinosaur? Yes, she said, but it's very basic. It's not decorated. It's $25 as is. And I said, let me see it. She had it in green, and I have one right here. And she had it in brown. I said, green. The first thing that I thought when I saw it, I said, I can fix it up. I can certainly do that because the shape is beautiful. It's a nice piñata. It's tall, as you can see right here. How tall it is. Well, I'm 5'3", so whatever. I don't know how tall she is or he is, but he's probably about 39 inches, maybe 40. And the piñata that I think at Walmart is about 36 inches or so. I think that's what the height on it was. So it's comparable, so $25. Let me show you the shape. It is fantastic. Okay, so you can see the head right here. See? Look at that. There's no flatness. There's plenty of dimension here, so oh, I love it. There's the little hands there, the legs. She's tall, or he's tall. I'm gonna lift them up a little bit here. So there we go. Oh, my ceiling fan. There we go. The legs right here, and look at the tail. So this is a pretty detailed piñata, and I thought with $25, it's very nice. But like I said, it is just a base piñata, and she sells them like this, but then she also, if you order it ahead, she will decorate it and add whatever you want to it. And well, you know, I said, well, I don't have time for that, but I can do it myself. So I went to the Dollar Tree because I thought, let me get some streamers, because this is made from that streamer crepe paper, you know, little streamers that you roll out and you decorate all over. This is what this is made with. It's just cut up like really fine. Let's put him over there. So I went to go get streamers at the Dollar Tree, but, and I wanted yellow. They only had a green, blue, and red. And I want to do the little chest part here, and I thought I would do yellow. I'll do red for the tongue, and I thought I'd redo the eyes. And I'm not sure now if I'm going to redo the eyes, because the eyes are not bad. But we'll see. Maybe I'll use a marker and color them. I don't know. But then I also thought I can take some of the darker green and maybe just add some little bits here and there and give him like little spots on his back, just to give him some little more dimension or color. Anyway, so I also got the stick. So I thought, oh, yellow. I love yellow. Would be great for his chest. I couldn't find yellow streamers, so I got, here we go. I got some yellow tissue paper because I thought, well, I'll just cut little strips and then I'll just cut real fine. And then I'll just cut whatever little bits I need to kind of slide in, you know, in front of, I'm going to slide, you know, put it on top of the green that he has here, but some of them has to like get tucked in some of the little bits on there, so you don't see the top edge. Okay, we'll get to that when we get to that point. Anyway, so so I've got a bunch of stuff here, guys. I went to this floral party supply store here in my town, and I got some styrofoam shapes. I got L-E-O for a Leo. Look at that. So I'm gonna paint these also so we can put them on the wall. And then I also found these. They're also styrofoam cut out with a little paper that gets glued on them. But look at that. Pterodactyl, I think. Don't ask. I don't know what this is. A raptor or something. And then, of course, like a T-Rex. So I thought these would be great to put on the wall. And I looked at the, she sent me a picture of the packaging of the stuff that she bought. And first I was going to pick out these really colorful little babyish kind of dinosaurs. They were so cute. And then I took a look at the picture again. I go, wait a minute. Those are actually like detailed pictures of dinosaurs on the stuff that she bought. And they happen to have that there. So I grabbed these. But I also got them in little smaller sizes. So I got the T-Rex again. And I got the raptor. And instead of the Velociraptor, I got this, what is a Brontosaurus? Hey, I know some of my dinosaurs, I have two boys, but anyway, there we go. I got those, and I thought these would be great for the cake topper, so I'll show you how I'm going to put all that together. And I thought, well, I wanted some tropical leaves and such for the, so I'm going to use a little bit from each of these things to add to that cake topper as well. I've got some extra stuff here, but that's just for other stuff. She mentioned a number 2 balloon for the cake topper. I found one there as well. I don't know how big it is. I just bought it. I bought the least expensive because I figured that was the smallest one that they had. But then I saw one on the wall and it looked kind of big. So, but that's okay if it's big. Oh, this is big. Of course, when it gets blown up, you know, won't look as big. It'll just puff out. But I think this is going to be working just fine. If we don't put it on the cake topper, we can put it on the wall, you know, where I put his name. I got some extra balloons. I did get a couple of candles because I don't know which one she would like to use for the cake. So I got this one. See, happy birthday, kind of a rainbowy. My husband liked that one. And then I got this one. It's an orange. It's kind of glittery. My husband said, that looks too girly. But I had grabbed it. I thought, well, I'll let my daughter-in-law decide, okay? But I have a feeling she'll choose this one. It's the most, you know, kind of kid and boy-like. So I think she'll like this one. I also did find this kind of a metallic too. Now, again, we don't use any of this, or, you know, I think we'll probably use this one. But these, I can save them for my nephew. He's going to be 2 in another year. But regardless, I can save all of that stuff. I went to the Dollar Tree and I got him a little dinosaur. The reason that I got this little dinosaur, let me show you some other little things. I'm just going to show you an idea of where my head was at. I didn't get any candy, but we can get that tomorrow in San Antonio. I need to find out what kind of candy is okay for him to have. As far as I know, my son has said that they really don't have any restrictions on him. That as far as like toys, we can buy him whatever we want. He said he's not going to, you know, he's not picky about, oh no, it has to be this kind of a thing or whatever. So he's not being picky about that. He just says, well, this is what he likes if you want to go with that, which is trucks and dinosaurs. Okay. Anything outdoor, anything to play outdoor also. So anyway, so like pinatas, you normally stuff them with candy. So when then you hit the pinata, all these candies fly out. And sometimes you can put, you know, some coins or some little toys in there. So I went ahead and I bought some little, I went just from the Dollar Tree. I got this little packet of little dinosaurs. I got this one with little airplanes because we had also thought about maybe he would like some little airplanes. I didn't get him an airplane toy, but maybe tomorrow when we're there, I'll actually buy him another present. I don't know. Oh, because I'm still buying him stuff because my mom also asked. She bought him something, but she's like, well, if you see anything else, buy it from me. Okay. So, because my mom and I share a credit card, so we just, whatever she wants, whenever she wants me to buy her something, I just use that card. Do you need to know that? No. But anyway. So here I got these other two from the Dollar Tree. This is getting to be a long video, guys, because I'm showing you a little haul of what I bought. Like I said, this I could veer off. So, but this is just an idea of what I'm doing. See? I got these two and they say Jurassic Park on them, but look how cute those things are. And they're small, but Leo's very smart and he doesn't put anything in his mouth, I think. Well, when we were there, he didn't put anything in his mouth. And then I got this cute little kind of sticker tape. This is, I also got it from that floral store where I bought those little foam animals or little dinosaurs. So I thought this would be cute to tape around the edge of the, I want to do the cake topper out of this. I want to put some, why am I telling you this? Let me just show you. Okay, everybody. I got balloons. I got these little, what are these things that you blow up and then the little thing swirls out? They're just called blobs. 8 fancy blobs. I went to the Dollar General and I got that too. And I got paper plastic table covers because I'm going to use one of these for the wall. But I also saw this. See how the design of this is different? But I said, well, you know what? I'm going to take it. It's a cute little, this is actually a wall mural. And I got this at the Dollar Tree. And I'm showing you all this just so I can get ideas. Look, a Dollar Tree has lots of great things. So this might be cute in the background also. Maybe, I don't know. We'll see once I get there. I bought a blow up palm tree. You know, why not, right? I also got this from the Dollar Tree, the little dangling things with little dinosaurs on the ends. We can hang, lots of possibilities, okay? At Target, I found these garland backdrop. See, they're leaves, and it's have two tones. And then you can hang them like that, as you can see. So maybe I'll hang that in front of the table cover. We'll see. So that's gonna be a future video. Oh, and I got this number two to also paint, to put on the wall with the word Leo, and then these big dinosaurs. So that's my haul, you guys. This is what I bought. I think it's the balloons, tissue paper, whatever. Okay, that's it, you guys. That's another table cover. Also at the Dollar General, I found this. It's a dino head balloon, and it's got a little thing that you put inside and it glows. So, and then it's got like little stickers that you stick on the top of the head to create the little horns up here. We'll see how this works. But I'm gonna let my son take care of that part. And okay, you guys, let's get to the piñata. All right, so I got this tissue paper that I thought that I would use in the tummy part. So I got one sheet, I'm gonna fold it in half, and I think, again, one more time. So what I want to do is I wanna make some really thin strips. I could probably fold it again once more. These are like really short. Let me go ahead and do that. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and cut at the folds. Just cut along. Goodness gracious. Why don't we open it up? Maybe that'll be easier. And I'll just follow the fold. Okay, and then I'll just cut this other one also. All right, so now that I've got 4 pieces, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually cut them one more time to make them even thinner. Let's see, let me fold this in half because maybe it's easier if I fold it in half and then fold it in half because it's a longer length to go cutting. And I'll do the same thing with the other one, but let me do this first and see how well this is going to work before I end up cutting a whole bunch of stuff, even though it's only one sheet of tissue paper. Let's see. Let's go ahead and open it up. I just cut along the fold here. Okay, so now that I have these, I can go ahead and start cutting the little fringe. And I need to make it really fine. So I'm just going to cut the ends over here, the folded ends. And then I'm just going to cut, let's see, right here. Really fine little fringes. So see that? And I'm not cutting all the way, you know, to the ends because we want them to stay together. So just cut like that. And then I'm going to see how much this does. So if I don't have to cut this and great, I won't cut that. But I'll have it ready just in case. And I'm going to try to just use one sheet of tissue paper. I think that'll be enough. Okay, so I'm going to continue cutting this and then we'll do the next step. All right, you guys, you're going to be hearing the fan in the background. Forgive me for that. I'm just really, really hot. I was doing a lot of running around and then I was cleaning a little bit. I don't want to leave my house a mess. Even because, you know, someone's going to stay here, so I don't want them to be in a messy house. But anyway, I went ahead and I took off the teeth. I don't really like them, so I'm going to take these off as well. So what I'm going to be doing, as well as adding some paper to this, some more decoration to this, I'm also going to like patch little areas like where this, you know, this is kind of flopping off and you can see the newspaper underneath. I just want to fix things like that, like right here where the nostrils are, because they're kind of misshapen there. And so I want to glue that down just so he doesn't look so torn up. But first I'm going to remove the teeth here because I don't like them. And I've already removed the ones on the bottom here. So I'm going to see if I have some. Now, I've already taken them off, so I'm going to have to figure out something. I think I have some white stiff foam. I'll show you that in a minute when I find it. Or if not, I'll use felt because I think I have white felt. So I'm going to cut out brand new teeth. I didn't like those. They're like made of a very thin kind of newspapery paper. And on the other side of it, it had some sort of a print. So I don't want that flopping over and showing. So anyway, so I'm going to fix that. And I am going to give him a little tongue. So I think I'll do that first as well. Okay, so before I fix this up here, I'm going to do the teeth and the tongue. But like I said, I'm going to fix little spots here and there where I see the paper kind of popping up. Now, I'm using my hot glue gun, but you can just use Elmer's glue, or, you know, any white glue, like, or Aileen's tacky glue, or the little glue stick. You just rub it on and then stick things down. But I want to do this fast because I want to dry quickly so that I can get on to my next project. So I'm taking the bits that I cut, little paper fringe that I cut to kind of match what they did. Now, this is a crepe paper, which is like the streamers, and that's what they use. And then it's cut, you know, it's cut into, you know, half of it is cut into this little fringe, and that's what is the pinata is covered with. So I wanted that, but like I said, I couldn't find any crepe paper in yellow, so I went ahead and I'm doing tissue paper. Anyway, I just lost my little piece, so I'm cutting another one. And then I'm also cutting a little bit off the top. I might have to turn off my little fan. Ugh. Anyway, so I'm just going to do a little bit at a time. So I'm going to lift the other part, the green, glue this down, and then glue this over. See how that'll hide that edge? So that's what I'm going to do, okay? So, but first let me get a longer one, a little bit longer, because I want to go short and then get longer and longer and then short again. So let me get another one. I think I had it in my hand. Yes, I did. I'm going to have to turn off my fan. Okay, so this one, I just want to cut it a little bit longer than this other one. So let's just cut it about right here. You can just cut it with your fingers. It's no big deal. Okay, let me get this one under there. And I'm going to glue this one down first at the lower area here. Make sure this is not getting glued under there. And then, actually, I'm going to do another row of that one, the same kind of length. Let's see. So you can just go like this, just gently cut it. I'm going to double it. There we go, just double that, make it nice and pretty. Okay, now I can add that shorter bit, and I'll probably double that up as well. actually. I have to go a little bit longer. There we go. You know what I'm going to need to do is, I know how to make pinatas. Don't ask me how I know. I just know. One of the many things you learn as a kid when you have parents or grandparents that are old school and they have to do everything themselves. You know, not only that, but you know, necessity. Hey, you want to do decorations for parties and you do it yourself. Okay, so now I'm going to go shorter. But again, this is too wide up here, so I'm going to cut that off. And then I'll try to center that a little bit more. So I'm kind of looking at it, making sure that I'm centering it as best as I can. And then just glue, little tiny little bits of glue. You don't need that much. Okay, now I'm gonna put this down so I can see how that looks compared. I like that. So now I'm gonna glue down the green to cover that edge. And there we go, just go like that. Okay, so see how that just blends right in? Okay, so now I'm gonna go under the other little bits here and I'm gonna add the same like I did there. Oh, actually there's another row right here. Let's go in this one. So I'm gonna go under this row here and I'm gonna add some here, the same width that I was doing, that wider one, and then stay the same, and then I'm gonna go small like that when I get to this point. I'm not gonna go too far down. So let's get again another piece that's about the same length. And then add the glue closer to the bottom. Anyway, I was saying, maybe I need to show you how to make a pinata from scratch. Just a small one, and I just make a little tiny one, and then, you know, it's up to you if you want to go bigger. So I need to just kind of refresh my memory. I know we used hangers, like those wire hangers, and then we used a lot of newspaper to, you know, to cover and create the shape, and then the little paper mache or these streamer papers is what you use. I remember using paper mache, the sheets of paper mache, and then cutting the strips, but I don't remember cutting it the fringes this finely. I remember them being more like what I just did over here, and we used to do like basket shapes, and I remember doing like little mini baskets as well, where we would put all the candy for the little favors for the kids, and all that candy was all like Mexican candies, and they were lots of peanuts, and there would always be an orange. You always have to have an orange in there. I also remember growing up, sometimes it was an apple. Okay, so look, see how that just blends in? But I want to put some more. Look, there's another area here where I miss. So I'm going to put some yellow in there. Now, what I could have done is I could have also, like, taken off, like, you know what? Maybe I'll do that just to show you. Take off some of the green fringe so that you'll just see yellow going down, okay? So I'm going to continue doing that, but you get the idea of what I'm doing, right? See? And then just put a little more glue there and just have this, you know, kind of glue downward. But you get the idea of what I'm doing. So I'm just going to work my way. I think from here on, I'm going to go smaller and just right here. Okay, I'll be back when that is all done. All right, everyone, so here it is. The little chest, I added some yellow. I think that looks really good. I'll stand it up and then I'll look at it and see if it looks even. I think it feels like I need like a little bit more here. And maybe just another little shorter bit over here. Actually, I'm really liking the way it looks. It matches with the rest of the work that's done to it. So it actually looks like that's supposed to be part of it. So there you go, you guys, little bits, little fringes like this, that'll help you. You can use that, or like I said, the streamer rolls, you can use that for this type of work. Okay, so I found some of this craft foam in my stash, and this one has some red, and I think this is sticky back. Yeah, it is. It actually has a sticker here, so I'm going to use a red for the tongue. And I just found regular, like white, and this is wide enough to go around like that. And then one on the top. So I'll cut some strips here like that. And then I'll do the teeth, the cutout. And just really simple. So the tongue, and I think maybe just a little piece like this. Let's see. And about so wide. Okay, and then I'm just going to round it off right here. So And round off the tongue. You can use a Sharpie and actually draw like a little line in the middle, but let's see if it'll stick on well with this. If not, I will use the hot glue. Oops. Oh my God, look at how much more character that gives that. So there we go, we're fixing him up real nice. Okay, let's do his teeth, and I'm gonna kind of lift this up a little bit right here. The one at the bottom, I don't have to do that to it. Okay, so let's trim off this right here. There we go, all this loosey-goosey stuff. Trim that off. Okay, and let's just glue that down so it doesn't move anymore. Okay, and then over here, you can hear my cat, you guys. Oh my goodness, of course, every time I'm busy, I'm sure you know if you're a cat, if you're owned by a cat, I should say. All right, so let me go ahead and cut a strip of this. So I'll do the top teeth first. I don't know, 2.5 inches, I don't know, something like that. Maybe this is 1.5. Okay, so it's not very straight, so let's straighten that up. Okay, like that. So this is the middle, and I'll go ahead and just do this. Like that. And I'll just fix that little bit right there. So see, I got some teeth now, like that. And these will look so much better than what was on there. And as a matter of fact, I have more of this green paper. It's not the same color, but it's the lip area, so it'll be okay. So I'm going to actually put this where it covers up, you know, this little mess here. And then I'll cut the green streamer and put one here. I'll cut the little, you know, this, what did I say this was? The fringe. Okay, there we go. So let me go ahead and glue that down, and I'll just put that right in the middle here so I can get that to hold on first. Right there. Yay! I'm so happy because this is working out. There we go, just like that. And there we go. Okay, now I'll do the bottom teeth the same exact way. Glue them down here. And then I'm going to get some streamer and put some streamer here to cover up. Make sure, because when I put this one down, this one doesn't have any little fringes on it. So I think I'm going to actually put this one down and then put the other streamer. Yeah, I'm going to replace that. Okay, so I'll fix all that. But first, let me put the other teeth and I'll come back to that. All right, so I've added the teeth. And like I said, I was going to add some of this streamer, this green one. So I cut some strips, and then I cut the little fringes, and then I put some here to cover that up. And that one piece that was kind of this other one that was kind of missing some fringes, that's somewhere in the middle here. And then I add more of this green on top, and I added another edging over here to cover, you know, just to kind of make it look a little more finished, a little more bushy down here, and to just give him that darker green. Now, it occurred to me that I could have done that in red because, you know, his lips, but then I thought, nah, I don't really want to give him red lips. So now I'm just going to add some glue here to bring this one down right here where these nostrils were, because that part kept, you know, kind of lifting, and it made these nostrils look really crooked. So I'm just fixing that up. There we go. And then look at right here where this eye is, right here, this lifts up. So that's what I'm doing, is just kind of fixing little areas here and there. Now, I like the way this, see how nice and neat this looks? I mean, you can't even, I mean, there's a little bit of difference in the greens, but it's not so much, you can't even tell. But I'm liking that, so I'm thinking I give him a little bit of a fringe right here, maybe add some more here and there, but I do want to, I thought about it a little more, and I decided that I want to give him more lizardy eyes. There's a little dot here, and that's a little circle, and I happen to have this black foam, and it's got this glittery look to it. I thought that would be really cool, so I'm really gonna just try to take off this little dot and maybe the white part. Yeah, there we go. I'm gonna keep this one because I need it as a pattern to see how big I can cut that white, the new white part. So I'm gonna use the foam board to cut out two whites, and then I'll use that glittery black to cut like a, instead of a round pupil, a long you know, lizardy type of pupil. Okay, that's all I'm gonna do. So, and if you don't have, obviously, you're gonna take off the eyes completely, then, you know, reshape them however you want. But I'm gonna do two, so I'm gonna go ahead and put this one on top. And if I go a little bit bigger, that'll be fine. And just try to do your best. Remember, this is a pinata. It's very cartoony, so, you know, you don't have to be perfect in any of this. Okay, so now that I've got these two white pupils, and I'm going to obviously cut out this one, I mean, take off that one as well. I'm off camera. I cut off a little strip like that. I just want to know how wide. So let's do this. And then I'm going to do this like that. And then I'm going to cut into it like that to do that. Do you see that? Yeah, that's going to look a little bit better. So I'm going to cut the other one. And I'm going to do it in the opposite way, so it'll be the contrasting. So I'm just going to remember the size for this top one here. So just cut them. And then just a little, let me make it a little bit bigger. There we go. Okay, so the one on the top was for this other eyeball, like that. And then I've got the other one for this one. So I'll glue that in on there, and then I'll glue this to the black. It's not perfect, but like I said, it doesn't have to. Actually, you know what? I think it should be like that. Okay, let me go ahead and finish these off camera because it's kind of hard to hold them up here and glue. So I'm gonna do this on the table, and then I'll glue them on, and then you'll see how that looks. All right, everyone. So here's a little sneak peek at the top of his head. As you can see, I added some more of this streamer here, the green, to fill in this little part because it seemed a little bald. And then I added a little bit of the yellow, and I'll show you the rest of what I did. But there's the eyes completed. There's his mouth. I think it looks so much better with his foam teeth here and the tongue. And then, of course, his little belly. And then I've glued down little areas where it was kind of, you know, the paper was kind of coming off. I glued it down. And then I decided to add a streamer around his neck to give him a little collar with a little medallion with an L for Leo. And then at the top of his head there, you can see, I just added a few little spikes. And I used that black glittery foam that I used in the eyes. And what I did is I did two pieces, each one of these little triangles. There's two of them, so they're back to back, so that I have the glittery side on each, you know, both sides of where, you know, depending on how you look at it. But you can see the glittery side there, you can see it there. And then I just glued them down, and I was thinking about doing the whole thing, but I said, you know what, I'm just gonna stop right there. I think that's enough detail. This is gonna go in my card. I don't want anything to get messed up, but I think he looks so much better. Look at that. And then I'll take a full picture of him for you to see it later, but I think it looks great. Let me bring the camera down. But there we go. All right, so now let me do the cake topper. All right, everyone, so here I've got the piece that's going to be for my cake topper. It is the base, so I'm using a piece of styrofoam. This is a 5-inch diameter, in case you're wondering. The thickness is probably about an inch, maybe an inch and a quarter or so. I don't know if it's an inch and a half, but it could be. Anyhow, I've got my little disc here, and I want to paint it, but I don't want to paint the bottom or the sides. I'm going to cover the sides. The bottom, I can leave it white, but I am going to paint this top part, and I want to paint it green. Now, initially, I had bought this little sticker, what is this little tape? It's a glittery blue, and I thought that I would just use that to cover the sides, and I thought it would look really pretty because, you know, it's blue. But then I was looking at my stash of ribbon. I just happened to glance over, and I remembered, and I saw this ribbon that has these little tropical leaves to it. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to glue it right on the edge here at the top part, and then I'll just cut it like that to fold it in on the bottom, or maybe I'll just trim it off. I'm not sure yet what I'm going to do. I may align the bottom part here. So anyway, I'll let you know when I get to that. Now, there's one thing that you want to keep in mind is that you want to make sure your little styrofoam is nice and clean, because you are going to be putting this on top of the cake. So what I am going to suggest is, before you put this on top of the cake, you know, you're ready to assemble, and you've got your cake ready, you want to put this on top, I would cut a piece of either wax paper or parchment paper the size of your foam piece here, maybe a tad bigger. Place that on the cake, you know, with your clean hands, and then you can place that on top just to be safe. If you're, you know, one of those people like me who are germaphobic, and especially at this time, you want to make sure everything's clean before you put it on top of something. Of course, you could, you know, clean it up, just wipe it off with something, you know, let it dry completely. And if you want to do it that way, that is up to you. Okay, because this is going to go on a food item, we just want to make sure it's clean. Okay, so I'm just going to paint the tops. I'm just going to squirt some green. And in case you're wondering about this green, this is Apple Barrel Spring Green. It's a really pretty color, but it doesn't really matter what color you use. I'm just using it to add some color here, some green, some ground grassy green. And it's a lot of it's going to get covered, but, you know, just to make sure. I'm just going to overlap on the edges just a tiny bit, like that. Okay, so we're going to let that dry completely. All right, so what I decided to do was to actually glue this little edge as close to the bottom edge here, so I don't have to fold anything underneath and then possibly causing it not to be level. So then this still needs to dry a little bit more, but I'm trying to hurry up because I'm actually packing at this time. So this is already getting close to the evening and I want to finish up. I got to drop off my dog and my kitty cat with my mama. All right, so let's see. Let's get this on the edge here. Okay, so that's all I'm going to do. Just glue it and then add a little bit more on this other top edge to catch the other part. So I'm going to glue it all the way around. And see, this ribbon happens to be wider than my styrofoam. So then what I'll do is that when I'm done is I'll just go around the edge right up against it. I will trim off the excess ribbon. Now, if the ribbon was too thin, of course, I'd do my first, you know, wrap around first and then do another wrapping around to get closer to the other edge. Like I said, this is still wet, so give me a little chance and I shall be back once all of this is placed on there. All right, so I've finished adding the ribbon and I trimmed it as needed, but there we go, it's nice and neat on there. And like I said, this pink is still a little bit wet. I was using a napkin to dab on there to help me get some of that off. Okay, so now I want to add these little characters. Try not to get any green paint on them. Just making sure the paint on my fingers is dry. Okay, so I really like the Tyrannosaurus right here in the middle. And I think I'm going to put maybe this guy kind of coming around like that. And then the other guy, the Brontosaurus. Maybe the Brontosaurus like that. Yeah. So in order to stick them in there, I do have this little wooden dowel here. I also have like this little plastic, this is for balloons. You can use like a straw or something like that to create a little stick. So all I need is just something, just enough to go into my figure here. So I'm going to put a little bit of glue on the end. Actually, you know what? Let me poke a little hole into that styrofoam. It'll melt it, make a little hole in there. Add a little bit of glue, push that in. Just like that. So that will hold it. So I want this to kind of pretty much lay flat on here. So I'm just going to cut it short, just enough to go into the styrofoam. And then maybe the other two, if I want them a little bit higher, I can cut the straw or the wooden dowel the length that I want it. So that's what you'll do. You'll just decide, you know, how tall you want these. You cut your straw or dowel stick the length that you need. Okay, so now I'm going to actually melt a little hole a little bit back here, put a little bit of glue in there. Now I can drop this figure right there, and it doesn't have to be all the way to the bottom. I just want it in there. Okay, so one figure in. I think I decided that I wanted to do these like kind of like maybe like a little bit, there we go, and then a little bit higher. So let me cut these a little bit longer. I'm just gonna guesstimate here. Right, and the other one. I'm making sure that this is all dry. I can see that it's a little bit wet. Okay, so, oops, I put this in there. Look at this, you guys. I'm not paying attention. Look, he needs to be like that. So let's make the hole over here. I just took a little look at this one to make sure that the sprout was coming out from the right, you know, the bottom end. Okay, so now this guy can be right here. And not so high. Let's cut a little bit off. I think that'll be good. Put the little straw there to melt, or the glue, the hot glue there to melt. And I can stick that in there. And then the other guy over here. And I think I'm going to cut him a little bit more too. Oops. And then just stick it right in there. Just like that. All right, so now I'm going to fill it in with the greenery. Actually, I'm going to move this out of the way. I've got all this greenery here. And then some with a little bit of yellow flowers in there. And I do have this really pretty glittery blue. And I had grabbed this because I thought, okay, it kind of coordinates with this. But I'm still going to use it. I think it looks pretty. It'll be like some water bursting out from behind the dinosaurs. That'll be great. Okay, let's go ahead and get this in here. I'm making a mess on my floor like you. Can't even, well, maybe you can imagine. If you're a crafter, you can imagine. Okay, so I'm just going to cut some bits of the greenery and start working my way. Now, somewhere here in the middle, I have this other straw here that I bought specifically for my balloon. It has a little plastic bit here that holds the balloon. You can find these at party stores. You can even find this online. It's just the straw for the balloons with a little. I forgot what this part is called. Well, we'll just call it a little balloon clippy thing here. Okay, so this is going to go right in the middle, but I'm not going to cut this yet. I'm not going to do anything to it yet. The balloon is going to go on here. I'm going to wait till I'm actually in San Antonio before we put this on the cake and let my daughter-in-law decide if she would like the balloon like really high or lower, or if she would rather have the number two or maybe the candle up high. We'll figure that out when we get over there. I'm just going to show you how to do the base, and I'm going to put it together just so you can kind of see what it's going to look like. And I might use a different balloon. And I do have more of those balloon sticks, so I'll cut one to size. Okay, so right now I'm just gonna add some greenery, and I'm angling it as I'm sliding it in. And actually, this is the greenery, the leaves here, they slide up, so I'm sliding it up to make it a nicer, fuller bit up at the top, because I don't need it to have such a long stem. I think I cut the other one a little too long. So this one's a little bit shorter. Just a little bit of glue, so it doesn't come apart on me, because this is going to travel. You don't have to glue this in. You can just insert them into the styrofoam. You can even do it while it's already on the cake. It's up to you. But I mean, look, this, you don't have to put all this together before, okay? I mean, you don't have to glue it together. All right, so one more piece of this big one right behind the T-Rex over here. I want some of these big leaves kind of coming out right here. All right. I'm going to take this one off because I feel like the stem is too long. I want these leaves to be a little bit lower. Okay, let's do that. Let's trim it. I'm going to put it in the same hole it was already in. I have been using a lot of hot glue and I am running out. So I hope I have enough to at least do this. And then I've got the styrofoam shapes to do Leo and the number two. And I've got to paint those. Look at that. So far it looks cute. All right, so I've got some more little bits here. I'm sliding all the grasses and leaves upward. And I'm just going to start filling in. I want it to look really lush. Alright, so this is what it's looking like so far. I'm going to continue adding more of all this pretty, pretty greenery until I am happy with how it looks. Alright, so I've added the large leaf in there, and I've added the grassy bits, and as you can see, it looks really full. But I want it to look really, really full, so I'm actually adding more of this other greenery. It's like a little mini little fern. So I've cut up some pieces, and then I'm just adding them in. Little areas that I see kind of bald, so just filling that in. I want it to look very lush, okay? That is what I want. And my phone is going crazy because I'm texting back and forth. My daughter-in-law has gotten out of work and she finally got my text. I knew she wasn't gonna get to see them till late, so that's okay. I don't wanna show her anything. I've told her, look, don't stress. I've taken care of everything. And she's like, oh my God, I'm so excited. And then I told her I bought a play pinata and I pimped it up. Oh, I can't wait to show her, but I wanna surprise them. And they won't be too tall, so they won't cover my little dinosaurs. They're just adding little bits of yellow from the little flowers. And of course, the little greenery is another different texture. So that's nice. Let's see. Okay. So that's what it looks like in the front. So I'm going to add more of those little yellow bits. That part will be done. All right, so I feel like I've added enough. I have this little bit left over. That's okay. I don't need to use that. I'd actually bought this big fern. I don't know what I thought I was going to do that, but I'm not going to use it. I mean, I might use the leaves for maybe for the background. I don't know. The photo backdrop that we're going to make. But look at that. Isn't that cute? Okay, so now I'm going to take this one, and I'm just going to trim it just enough stick here to insert into the styrofoam. And these guys, if you come from the back of them, and you do this, they'll curl. There you go, a little bit more, there we go. Don't make me a liar, these do curl. Okay, I got two here, that's why it feels so thick. Okay, let me do one. Let's see the little curls that it creates. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna do every single one of them, but I wanna do as many as I can. So let me go ahead and then I'm going to put this in the middle towards the back here. So I'm going to give it some height here, right there like that, okay? Big old topper. But I'm not going to glue this in. I'm going to actually hold this and wait till we are out over there at their house in San Antonio before I insert it. But I wanted to show you how that's going to look. So I'm just going to hold it up against here. There we go. See? And then I'm hoping that the balloon also will be on here. But this gives you an idea of a little topper that you could create. Actually, this doesn't even have to be a cake topper. This can be a little centerpiece on the tables, on the party table. So, and then add a stick here with a balloon on top of it. But I hope that you get the idea. I'll take a picture once we're over there, and that'll be on another little video. I just wanted to do a video today and show you what I'm doing before I leave. All right, everyone, I think I finished for this video. I do have a couple more things that I want to paint, which are his name, Leo, and then the number 2. So I'm just going to paint these like I did the little styrofoam base, just with some craft paint. I might sprinkle a little bit of glitter on them. So when you see them next week, you'll know that they were just plain little styrofoam letters like this, and then I just painted them with craft paint. And then, of course, I've got my little straw here with my little holder, my little clip here for my balloon that will go on here. It's either going to be a regular balloon or it'll be that number 2. It's a foil number 2 balloon that I have, but I don't want to blow it up because, of course, I don't want to waste it. And then this will go in my arrangement here with the balloon right here. Maybe it'll go lower. We might cut this down. I don't know. But here's my little cake topper, which, like I said, it could be a little centerpiece. There's my grandson. Look at that. So I decided I should put that right in there for now. Anyway, so also my big project of the day was to dress up the piñata. So there he is. Gorgeous. Look at that. And here's the back so you can see his little bits there, his scales. But he looks fantastic, and I really think the little collar added on there really did something. I mean, just a little bit, a little touches, you guys. A little bit of yellow here up on the top. Fix a little bit of the, you know, the bits that are on there. You find yourself a plain piñata and it doesn't quite have everything you want to on it. Fix it up. Replace things on it. It's super easy. Just takes a little, a little imagination and just a few little bits of craft paper or foam or, you know, whatever. You know, tissue paper is what I used here because I couldn't find the crepe paper that was actually used for the piñata here and the streamers. I didn't have them in yellow, but I used tissue paper, so that worked really well. And I'm really happy with it. I love them so much. The idea that I have is that they won't bust this up. They'll just put it in his room and let Leo play with it, hug it, whatever he wants to do with him, destroy it as he wants to. But I think that we can pretend, let him hit the pinata. So my idea is that we're going to have the candies, maybe some little toys in our hand, and then we just kind of toss it there on the ground as he hits it. So he thinks it came out of the pinata. And then we can just control how much candy or, you know, little toys he gets, and then he wouldn't actually have to break it. Unless my son says, no, we want to break the pinata, then we're going to go ahead and let him do that. But look, you guys, I think it was well worth the time to fix it up because I think it's going to make them very happy when they see the piñata. I think it'll make Leo super excited when he sees this. Leo, I love you very much, mijito. Lots of kisses. Happy birthday. Thank you all very much for watching. I'm going to give myself a big old thumbs up, and I hope that you too will give me a big old thumbs up and leave a kind comment below and let me know what you thought of my piñata. And wish my grandson happy birthday, you guys. Subscribe if you haven't already subscribed, so hit that red button down below and then hit that little notification bell so that you get notified of when I upload my videos, and I try to upload 2 videos every week. So take care of yourselves, everyone. I love you very much. Share on your social medias, and as always, enjoy.